Thank you for invitation. First of all, I will not talk about COVID. I'm not an epidemiologist, social and economic researcher. So COVID is some kind of framework, and we will discuss the situation in Russian regions connected with COVID, but not only with COVID. There are additional big problem Russia face in this spring, which influence on the Russian budget, Russian industries, and so on. First, you have to take into account that we faced new crisis, not finishing the previous one. It was the crisis of December 14, and the crisis was long, and I show you the drop, one quarter of the same quarter, 1 year to the previous year, of the main indicators. And you may see the drop of investment. It was very huge in 15. You may see the drop of retail. It was the same dip. And the drop of money incomes in real prices. And it continues till the end of 18, and only in 19, it was a very small growth. I will show you the total dip, not year to year, but from the beginning to the end. It means that we faced new crisis, not without recovering many drops of previous crisis. First, it's in industries. Now we have only the information about January, April dynamics, but I did prepare two types of figures. This is January, April total of this year to the previous one. These are blue. And this is only April. When the lockdown started, it started in the end of May. And you may see that two-thirds of Russian regions drop. And this drop is continuing. April to April was 7%, May to May, 10%. Russian industries are mainly industries of two types. First one is exporting industries, and the global markets now are very problematic for these industries. So that's a shrinkage. And the second group are domestic industries, and they faced two problems. First one, lockdown, some of them stopped work. And second, the huge drop of consumption. So this crisis is different compared with 2015. In previous one, there were no big drop of industries. The problems were, let me repeat, investment, money incomes, and consumption, retail. Now, Russian industries face the problem as well. Second, investment. We know nothing about what has happened during this crisis itself, because the Russian regional statistics is very slow, and now we have information only about first quarter. But it is interesting because you may see the continuation of the old trend. Look at this. Sorry for Russian letters. What are the big districts faced growth and decline? First one is Europe, where the oil main Russian oil and gas extracting industry are concentrated. Second one is South districts. It's not so big in terms of investment, but the main place for investment now is surroundings of Crimea Bridge. Roads to this bridge and something like this. So only due to this geopolitical factor, southern district is still growing. And third one is Moscow. Moscow, despite all the problems, are gathering investment very stable. Please remember, Moscow and the main oil and gas extracting regions, and additionally some geopolitical projects. If you look at the investment on previous years, you will see the absolutely same trends. This is share of investment which are going to the different regions. The red is Moscow. Moscow share percentage. And Moscow region, the whole agglomeration. 15, Moscow and Moscow region. 20 and 19, Moscow and Moscow region, 21. Every fifth ruble goes to Moscow agglomeration in Russia. It shows the real priorities of investors because about 85% of investment are not from the budget. They are from different sources. And the second place for investment is Tumen region. Look at this, please. Light brown. This year and this one. It's about 11-14%. Two places of Russia, year by year, are gathering one third of total investment in Russia. And it will not change after Corona crisis, because these territories have the biggest competitive advantages. So all the other regions are losers compared with these two. Next. What are the features of coming crisis? First one is housing construction. -8%, it is percentage of drop from 15 to 19. То есть this is a situation created by the previous crisis. We are still below the level of 18. And additionally, in the beginning of this year, -10%. And you may see the drop is big enough and it is located in two thirds of regions. So the idea to recovering new crisis via support of development, I think it's not so easy to do because the trends are different. Next slide. The huge drop of retail. By the end of 19, we have the total retail turnout -8% compared with 14. We have not recovering. And additionally, in April, -23. I'll check the next month. I think May would be the same drop, but in June, the lockdown has been easing, and so the figures will go up, but one fourth, it's a big enough crisis. And you may see that all regions faced this problem, excepting Chukotka. It's exotic place with a very poor statistics. Next is unemployment. And there are many questions about unemployment dynamics. Officials say that growth was not so big. Before Corona crisis, COVID crisis, the unemployment rate in ILO methodology was very low, 4.6 in February. And our Minister of Social, of Trade and Social Care announced that now it's about 6. And by the end of May, about 6. And the number of people unemployed in methodology ILO grew grew additionally 1 million only. Only 1 million. It's very strange because the many other researchers show that the number of people unemployed was 10 or 12. But Rostat had no abilities to make usual research in for estimating unemployment rate. They called people by telephone. And I did it last time, as I know, in April. So why our ministers told that the unemployment rate is 6? It's very strange. All researchers make forecasts in terms of 7-8, but it is not tragic because we faced in 90s unemployment rate 10, 11, and 12. In the crisis of 2009, it was 9. So the unemployment rate will grow not so dangerously, let me say so. But if you look at the other statistics, registered unemployment rate, it's a very fantastic growth. By mid-June, it was nearly 2.5 million people. Before the crisis, it was extremely low. 1%, and now it's 3%. What happened? Why people went to the services? The reason was very simple. Federal authorities announced the growth to subsidy or benefit, how to pronounce properly, for unemployed, it grew nearly 3 times. And now it is equal to subsistence minimum level in the region. So people see that money now not so weak. It's about 100 in different regions. And in the middle, it's about 130 euros. But for Russians, these are money. So unemployment rate is continuing to grow. But the question is how many resources will be given from federal budget to pay for unemployed registered in services? The number of money has grown 5 times, but this subsidies is itself grew 3 times. So we were waiting for what will be the new dynamic of June. I think we are very close to maximum 3%, because there is no more money to support, and some people try to find jobs and different reasons, and they will pay the unemployment. People will be paid only 3-4 months normal. Next, what can we say about geography of a registered unemployment rate? In absolute number of people, maximum growth was in Moscow region, Sverdlovsk, Tatarstan, the big Russian regions. It's easy to understand. They are big, many people live, and so the number of people who went to make a registration was maximum. Maximum unemployment rate in registered unemployment growth, the maximum was in Siberia Republic, but it's very necessary to strengthen, to say that the fast growth was in many industrial regions. And it's very surprising for me because industries are not so drastically beaten by crisis. Further, I'll explain who are the victims of this crisis in the biggest level. But what can we say about the support of people? This is the picture of Lilia Avcharova, my colleague, and the best Russian professional in terms of research of incomes, poverty, inequality. This is the special accounting of factors which create poverty. Many years in Russia, the main factor was territory, the region where you are living. If you live in poor region, it creates poverty. If you live in rich region, it helps you go out from poverty. But from this decade, the main factor has changed. And now it's the number of children. How many children in your family? Because demographic measures from Putin's demographic politics more or less stimulated to have more children, but the financial base was very poor because so-called maternal capital, you are not able to research immediately. You may spend it only on housing, on education, and only last year, some portion of this maternal capital could be allowed to spend day by day needs. But this is the main risk zone in Russia, families with children. And if we look at regional picture, I may say nothing, because only first quarter statistic is available. So it shows small, very, very slow growth. There are few number of regions with decline. It's about nothing. The problem is that the statistic concerning second quarter, we will see only by the end of August. No early. This is specific of Russian statistics. It is estimating quarterly and additionally 2 months to count. So by the end of August, I will be able to say and think about what is happening with money income dynamics. But we have a focus. Let me show you several. It's not, of course, not my focus. I am not a macroeconomist and not a social economist. Look at these figures. These is figures I gathered from the focus of High School of Economics and Russian Academy of National Economics and Public Administration. Poverty rate for the second quarter only will grow from its modeling. It's modeling in big data, in a system of panel data, manual. Will grow from 12.5 to nearly 16. It's for second quarter of this year. And in this modeling are included the special subsidizing measures from federal authorities which support families with children. It was absolutely right decision, but they give families with children from 3 to 16 years subsidy, 10,000 rubles, about 120 euros, once, only in the second quarter. In the period was the end of May and the beginning of June, once, no more. For children, for families with children no older than three years, they added stable subsidies monthly. And for children from 3 to 7 years old, they allowed a new subsidies more or less stable. So it helped to minimize the growth of poverty rate. Without this support, it would be about 20%, every fifth Russian citizen. After modeling, my colleagues told it will be about 16. Number of poor will grow from 18 to 23, but we have the same figures and worse in the beginning of previous decade. It's nothing new. The most interesting is that despite this additional support, the poverty in Russia will continue to have a child phase. The share of poor among families with children, every fourth. Even in second quarter, with taking into account that additional support, the share with children 16 years old, nearly half, because the support was made only once, 10,000 rubles, nothing more. And it shows that the poverty rate, maybe it will not jump very high, but it will stay in the higher level long enough time, and mainly for children, for families with children. The forecast for real money incomes decline differs, many of them. Most optimistic, minus four. It's very strange because GDP consensus forecast is about minus five. And how the Russian population incomes will drop slowly. It's very difficult to imagine this situation because all Russian crisis, the GDP drop was not so deep compared with personal money, real money income drop. And the most realistic forecast is about 7%. What are the additional difficulties? First one, loans bubble. Last 3 years, the loans, people, bank were very kind to the people and gave lots of loans for, not only for mortgages, but for usual loans to buy something. And now the sum, the amount of loans is more than 18 trillion rubles. To compare, it's about the same figures like federal budget, And the regions with these loans, I counted the amount of loans for physical, for person, not for businesses, for population. And in the previous crisis bubble, and now by the end of 19, and you may see that nearly all regions have higher level if we count loans to annual personal incomes of population of these regions. It's very dangerous because the incomes and salary drops. You have to pay for your loans. Now federal authorities told you may postpone this payment, but only postpone. And families will face the big problems. And additional problems, it's a huge drop of payment paid services. Paid services, first of all, these are two one. First one is housing and supplyment services, electricity, hot water, and all these connected with housing. And the second one is transportation, public transportation. These are the biggest portion of paid services. At the UMC, the huge drop on all regions. Totally 38%. Why? First idea is very simple. Lockdown, people do not go to jobs, university, school. They don't use public transportation. It's true. But the pressing of lockdown was very different in regions. Most harsh. It wasn't hard. It was in Moscow and St. Petersburg, not in all around the country. The main reason: people do not pay for housing. They were allowed not to postpone. I don't know how to translate it in English. In Russian, it's penny. It's punishment. If you do not pay properly, you have additional percent of punishment, you know, penny in Russian. And our federal authority told, well, okay, no punishment till the end of 2000 of this year. No punishment. And people stopped to pay at all, at all. And January 1st, 2021, they will face huge amount of problems and starting the punishment. Yeah, and my English don't allow to explain more clear, but I think you don't pay for a long time, but you have to pay later without additional incomes. What about the risks? First and the main risks, do I have 5 minutes more? Yeah, or not?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. The biggest risk is concentrated in the biggest cities, not in peripheries, not in industrial towns, in the biggest cities, because the huge bid was upon paid services. Lockdown, drop of incomes, poverty growth, and many people in lockdown stopped to work without payment. The risks were very big. Not of all of them went to employment services, small portion. Many of them were waiting, and a typical Russian instrument for crisis adaptation is short-time employment. You are not fired, but you have no salaries, or you receive a small portion of your wages and salaries. It's very typical for paid services, because among them, mainly small and medium-sized businesses, they have no additional money to survive during this period. And here I show you the number of people working in these services, paid services. More than 10 million people without transportation. If we wait on transportation and some additional services, it may grow to 15. It's the biggest part of non-public sector workers. The biggest part, it's not in industry, it's a big. So the risks were very high. And I estimated the share of these people in every region. They are not unemployed. These are people under the big risks. And we will check how many businesses will fire, how many people will be bankrupts. The Professional Association of Medium-Sized Businesses, so-called Деловая Россия, calculated and announced that it will be about 20% of bankruptcy among the medium-sized businesses. But small businesses, let me say only 10% of small businesses receive any form support of the state. 10%. Huge restrictions, very rigid system. So small businesses, as well as medium-sized businesses, are not interesting for this thing. Pay attention, first of all, of big businesses paying the main portion of taxes. Subject is budgets. Here only a picture to show you what is the difference between Russian regions. How many of regions received the biggest portion of their revenues from in form of transfers. All of these regions, these are underdeveloped republic mainly, some far eastern regions, all of these regions will pass the crisis easier compared with more developed because they have stable money from the federal budget transfers. And these regions, they have not so big support because they are more developed. And now developed regions faced the biggest drop, the biggest cities with services, oil and gas extracting regions, metallurgical in terms of global shrinking of activities, all those who pay profit tax in regional budget, who have their own money to support their population and businesses, first of all, small and medium, a few. Of course, Moscow, her budget per capita revenues and spendings are 2.5 times higher compared with Russia average. Sakhalin oil extracting region, but now revenues are shrinking drastically. Tumen and its autonomous districts. Maybe St. Petersburg, please compare the per capita budget money, Moscow and St. Petersburg. Kaliningrad is a different story. It's about support of open economic zone, special economic zone. And Crimea is Sevastopol, but they receive money like transfers and not for payment for business, for construction of infrastructure. To show the whole world that Russia is a good investor in a new territory. No money to support population and small and medium-sized business. It means that nearly all depends on federal decisions. What is happening in the side of revenues? This is April data. You may see the total drop. All taxes, only taxes without the transfers. It's about in all regions. There are special cases. I have no time to explain. This is a monthly situation, very specific, connected with the rules of payment of profit tax of big companies. The drop of personal income tax. Salaries and wages, minus 18, only for April. Totally, the drop is about 350 or nearly 400 billion rubles. It's about 3% of total revenues of region's budget. 3% in April, 3% in May, and maybe 1-2% in the other months. And total forecast for a region's budget drop, two actors made it, High School of Economics and how to translate Счетная палата, who can help me? Where Kudrin works now.
Yeah, accounts chamber.
Accounting chamber. Yeah, okay. The same figure. 1.3 trillion drop of tax revenues for regions. It's about 10% of total revenues of regions. 10%. And the problem is, who will cover these problems, this shrinkage of revenues? I'll explain in the last two slides. Additionally, you may say, if you have no money, go to bank and ask for loans. The problem is that many regions are still have a very big loans in terms of number amount of loans to the annual number of money of taxes, not transfers, taxes which regions earn itself. And you may see 40, 50, 60, sometimes more than 1.5 times higher. These regions are not able to go to banks. First, the problem, the Ministry of Finance have huge restriction. I suppose they will be more and more mild because federal budget don't like to cover all the shortage of regions budget. And then the result will be very clear. Now the level of the level of loans compared to their own revenues is 22%, and Standard & Poor's focus is by the end of this year 30%, and these regions have to pay persons and the whole loan itself several future, several years in the future. And the two last slide, look at the first one, how federal authorities help regions. I show you the drop of revenues in April. In May, federal authorities add region 100 billion rubles. In April, 200. The last portion was divided between different regions. And I counted. I counted simple thing. What was the drop? And what was the recovery by federal support, federal money? And it's very interesting, it's Russia. 10 regions were recovered totally. 22, half and maybe more. 22, less one thought some 2-3% only. No compensation, no support, 13 regions. There are some regions which did not receive it. It's true, the most richest, Moscow, Tumen, Sakhalin, no need. The most poor, because total support by transfers. But why 13 regions received nothing? No answer. It's a typical of how the decision are making. It's very non-transparent. And last my slide. Here I gathered all my conclusions and first I was wrong when thought that industrial output will be not so deep. I suppose it will be deep enough with very slow recovery as well as GDP. Second, investment decline for a long time, I'm absolutely sure. Money incomes, I explain you, no idea what the figure, what would be the figures of decline. We are waiting. Regional budget will be covered if you look at announcement of our state, federal, prime minister for future additional payment. He announced 350 billion more. 200, 100, and 3.5. As maths shows, 650. But drop will be 1,300,000,000,000. How they will cover, I don't know. I don't know, but my experience shows me that in September will end more, because in September, in many Russian regions, will start the regional electoral process, governor's elections, parliament elections, and so on. So will end. Because political reasons are the main reasons in Russia, not idea to support region itself. What, who feel themselves the worst? regions have a chance. Small and medium-sized business have no chance. Minimal support, very inefficient support, and they will face bankruptcy, many of. And they will have tragic problems for many families. And what about political reasons? I don't know. We clearly know that discontent is growing, but what will be political consequences? God knows. Things